Hello everyone and welcome to lecture number 3. In the last lecture we have seen that if suppose this is a semiconductor and the shape of the semiconductor is different as compared to the last lecture, it doesn't matter. We have seen in the last lecture that if a photon is incident on a semiconductor, and if the photon energy, we know the well-known equation E is equals to hc by lambda, where let us say photon x. Now if the photon energy Ex is greater than the band gap energy of a semiconductor, as we all know that semiconductor will have band which is valence band and conduction band. We all know that semiconductors will have band gap, valence band will be there, conduction band will be there, and the gap between these two bands is nothing but Eg. This is nothing but Eg. So the condition to generate an electron hole pair is, if the photon is incident on a semiconductor, if that photon is having energy greater than the band gap energy, if Ex, the photon energy, is greater than the band gap energy, then that photon will generate an electron hole pair. A hole will be generated and electron hole pair will be generated like this. Hole will be in the valence band, electron will be in the conduction band. Now this is nothing but the simple generation of electron hole pair, right? But we are interested in studying that how this generated electron hole pair generated with the photon can be converted to current and voltage. Now this criteria is very important. Now remember one thing. Now let us assume that this is a p-type semiconductor. Right. And we have an n-type semiconductor. N-type semiconductor connected to it. Right. This is an p-n junction. This is p-type. This is n-type. This is p-type, this is n-type. Now as we know, we have seen in the second lecture, the previous lecture, that p-n junction will have an electric field. P-n junction will have an electric field in this direction. Electric field in this direction in the space charge region. in the space charge region. Now, imagine that a photon X is incident on a p-type material, and that Ex is having greater than Eg, then Ex is having energy greater than the band gap energy of this semiconductor Eg, then it will generate an electron hole pair. This is valence band, this is conduction band, this is Eg. This is Eg. So it will generate an electron hole pair. Now, if this electron, will come across this field, then as we go there, electric field will try to have a force of attraction for electron in this direction, right? If a field is there facing electron, it will have a force of attraction for the electron to move into the another direction. The electron in this way will try to go from P side to N side. This is nothing but, drift of electron. This is nothing but drift of an electron. In the same way, holes from N side will have a force of attraction in the opposite direction due to the presence of this field. Holes will have force of attraction in the opposite direction. So holes will go in the opposite direction, while electrons will go towards the field. Right? This is electron. It will go in this direction. Right? Is it fine? Now, this is the case. For one electron, one photon generating one electron hole pair. This is the case we have seen. For one photon generating one electron hole pair. Now, in practice, instead of this one electron, there will be n number of photons. Incidentally on a semiconductor. So there will be n number of electron hole pairs generated. For n number of photons. So we will be having more number of electrons as the photons will be generated, electron hole pairs, electrons will be drifted towards N side, holes will be drifted, Due to this, huge number of electrons in the N side and huge number of holes in the P side. This will try to generate, this will give to generate the photovoltaic potential. This is nothing but a generation of potential. If you measure across these two terminal, then this will be more negative, this will be more positive. As because this side is more consisting of electrons, this side is more consisting of holes. This will be more negative, this will be more positive. This is nothing but the generation of photovoltaic. This is the picture of a PN junction. Now we will see that how this electron hole pairs will be generated and electrons and holes will be moving in the opposite direction due to the presence of this magnetic field with respect to its band gap. Right? Now, we know that P-type semiconductor and N-type semiconductor Fermi levels are different. Let us say this is a P-type semiconductor energy band diagram. Right. This is valence band. This is conduction band. Now, in the same way, N-type material will have the energy band where the Fermi level will be near to the conduction band. This Fermi level in P-type material will be near to the valence band. This Fermi level is nothing but the level, energy level at which the maximum electron can, the probability of finding a maximum electron is possible. That is nothing but the Fermi level, right? The Fermi level will be near to the valence band edge. In N-type semiconductor, the Fermi level will be near to conduction band. This is valence band. This is conduction band. Valence band and conduction band. Now, what happens to this energy band diagram when PN junction is formed? We know that, this is the symbolic representation of PN junction. But what happens when what happens when these two Venn diagrams will be combining? What happens when these two Venn diagrams will be combining? So what happens to its energy levels? That we will see. This is how the Venn diagram looks like when a p-n junction is formed. When a p-n junction is formed, this is n-type. As we causing n-type, the Fermi level will be remains closer to the conduction band, and in p-type, the Fermi level will be closer to the valence band edge. When p and n-type semiconductor are combined to each other, their energy band diagrams look like this. They will try to have a band bending in the energy band diagram. Now, over here, we will also show the presence of an electric field. The electric field in the p-n junction is in this direction. This is P type. This is N type. The electric field in the PN junction will be in this direction, right? So, the similar way, electric field we can show over here as the electric field can be shown in such a way in the space charge region, right? Now, let us assume that a photon is incidenting over here. It is generating an electron hole pair. It is generating an electron hole pair. So, this electron will be exerting a force to move towards opposite direction due to the presence of this field. And in the same way, and another electron hole pair is generated in the N side. This hole will try to have a force of attraction. This hole will have a force of attraction to move towards P side. In the same way, this is for one photon, this is for one photon, for n number of photons, this is for one photon, if n photons, then there will be more number of electrons in this side and more number of holes in this side. This is nothing but if we have a contact on this side, if we can take a contact on this side through any wire, this will be more positive, this will be more negative due to more number of electrons. This will be more positive due to more number of holes. This is nothing but generation of photovoltaic. This is nothing but generation of photovoltaic, right? Now, if we try to measure the flow of current through this, we will also get the flow of electrons. We will also get the flow of electrons in this direction. That is nothing but photovoltaic current. So this is how a solar cell works. Now, as we know that we have studied PN junction under different bias condition, under forward bias and reverse bias, but remember one thing, here we are not giving any kind of bias to solar cell. We are not providing any kind of bias to solar cell. This is working in unbiased condition. Why? Because bias is nothing but we will provide the source voltage from outside. But over here, the concept of solar cell is that it itself is generating photovoltaic and photocurrent. So we are not giving any kind of bias. This is the most important thing. This is the most basic difference between the solar cell and a PN junction diode. Though solar cell is a PN junction. Even solar cell is a PN junction, right? Okay, thank you.